Hey, welcome back, folks. So let's just get straight to business today. No fluff. You know, there's this thing called sucralose, also known as Splenda, which is essentially taking over America. I know it's been around for a little bit, but man, it is getting steam right now. In 2020, there were 51.4 million people, million Americans that is, that used Splenda. Isn't that crazy? You know, the synthetic sweetener. And almost $300 million was spent by consumers this past year on Splenda / sucralose products. Out of control. Out of control. You know, I see so many patients who are engaging in intermittent fasting, or they're doing time-restricted eating or feeding, and they're unknowingly compromising or sabotaging their progress in that they are consuming non-caloric sweeteners such as sucralose, you know, putting them in their coffees or their teas, or they're drinking, you know, Zevias or these things that are no calories, but are unfortunately sabotaging their insulin response or their sugar response, and they're basically making it so that sweet taste is actually stimulating the release of insulin. And you know, the release is pretty short. But you know, if you drink something over, you know, half an hour, it's like, geez, insulin's being released the whole time. And metabolic sabotage is happening because most people are intermittent feeding, intermittent fasting right now in an effort to get their insulin resistance under control, or to increase the sensitivity of their body to insulin, and to get to those fat stores and you know, get some of that hip fat, the abdominal fat off their body, you know, put that fat to use as an energy source. But yeah, if we're consuming, you know, packets of sucralose in our coffee, that's not happening, folks. So what is sucralose? Big question, right? Sucralose is the synthetic sweetener. Like I said, it's a chlorinated sugar molecule. It's not natural, though people like to promote it as natural because it came from sugar originally. But basically, they take a sugar molecule, they splice off some hydrogen molecules and or elements, and they stick chlorine in its place, in the hydrogen place. So no big deal, right? The only problem is once you cut off these hydrogen ions and you stick on the chlorine ones, it completely changes the structure and the function of the substance. This, and now we have something that's doing something entirely different than just a sugar, which is, you know, often in excess in America as well, but may not be having these intense properties as something like Splenda. So, you know, Splenda, it's like 700 times sweeter than sugar. Really sweet, right? But as well as that sweetness, Splenda also reduces beneficial bacteria in our gut and increases body weight. Crazy, right? And I'm not talking about the lean mass that we all enjoy, you know, the muscles, the abs. I'm talking about weight gain from a fat point of view. Also, swapping in sucralose interferes with a nutrient and drug absorption because it affects an enzyme or a detoxification enzyme called cytochrome P450. And so you literally could be, you know, trying to get nourishment in your body, and by putting Splenda, aka sucralose, in your body as well, you're actually disrupting the capacity for you to get nourishment. Who wants that? And on top of that, if you have inflammatory bowel disease, say Crohn's disease, which this one study was done on, unfortunately, you can expect an overgrowth of E. coli in your gut and something called intestinal ileus, which intestinal ileus is basically where you get a loss of the ability to control muscle contractions in the intestine. So lots of spasming, gas, bloating, all that kind of stuff. You know, maybe just diarrhea out of the blue. Sounds great, right? No, it doesn't sound great at all. But there is also a 2020 study looking at otherwise healthy individuals between the ages of 18 and 35. You know, that's a pretty robust age, right? Who they gave sucralose to, and they showed an increase in what? Insulin resistance, and an increase in or an exaggerated response to glucose when they would eat something with actual sugar in it. And to think, you know, a person has diabetes or they have metabolic syndrome, or, you know, a person wants to lose weight, won't lose fat. And so they go and grab Splenda, grab sucralose, and we're going to put this in our baking products. I'm going to get something that's sugar-free, that has Splenda in it, put it in my coffee. And unfortunately, because of the lies of marketing and these manufacturers, they're actually doing the exact opposite for themselves. You know, they're actually building a bigger hole for themselves in the end. You know, they get that initial, you know, maybe, oh, no calories. But then as gut flora starts changing, as, you know, the inflammatory products of gut flora changing occurs, as insulin is consistently resistant and the sensitivity is lost, they end up with higher blood sugars. They end up with more diabetes. They end up with more fat gained and less control of their appetites. Because a digestive tract, a gut that is out of balance, you know, flora that's been messed up and changed into a undesirable group of bacteria, you're messing with human biology. And human biology, man, once it gets messed up, you know, it's challenging to get it back on board when we're talking about these flora. So sucralose is not inert. I know Johnson & Johnson claim that, you know, their patented, essentially, drug, their organochlorine drug that sits on all these shelves in these grocery aisles, this sweetener, this yellowish, you know, box or bag, pretty big bag usually, it is not inert. It does have negative effects on the body. But you can't expect a manufacturer's study to reveal the negative effects of a product that's going to, you know, bring in hundreds of millions of dollars for them a year, right? So that's why we have to look to studies that are not from the manufacturer. Always a good thing, whenever you're looking for studies on what a product is doing, or, you know, especially when we're talking about side effects, it's a really good idea to say, okay, who's telling me this has no side effects? This has no potential to do me harm. There's nothing wrong with this thing for any shape or person anywhere. Probably the manufacturer's one that put in that study, because otherwise there's opportunity for side effects from virtually everything. All right, so how about cooking with sucralose? Is that okay? Can I bake with it? What do you think? It's often promoted, you know, for baking, and it was like direct shoot sugar substitute. The taste is just right, just like you're eating sugar, except for there's no calories. However, there's more studies out there, folks. And in 2022, the Journal of Food Chemistry, they did a study on sucralose and heating it. And they found that at high temperatures, you know, just via simple baking or cooking, sucralose, that it actually generated a toxic group of compounds. Who would have thought? And this toxic group of compounds are called chloropropanols and dioxins. Many have heard probably of dioxins before. These are not wholesome things for our body. These are going to promote dysfunction and disease, folks. So personally, I would eat cane sugar every day of the week, rather than consume Splenda, aka sucralose, or, you know, a chlorinated sugar like sucralose. Though, of course, eating bags of sugar is not the answer to the fact that you're gonna be rid of Splenda forever after watching this video, right? But at least the sugar came from a source and it's still that same molecular structure as it was when it was in the cane sugar, right? So I really hope this video gets you stirred to drop that yellow bag of Splenda. Leave it in the cart at the store, bypass it for yourself, for your family. If you have it in your refrigerator, go out to the burn pile and burn it, throw it in the garbage can and say, you know, sayonara, that 10, 15, 13, 20 bucks, it's just not worth it. Your body is worth so much more than any bit of Splenda sweetening could ever offer it. All right, folks, Dr. Matt here. Hope this is helpful. Like, share, subscribe, and more health accumulation opportunity coming your way. Splenda, not health accumulation opportunity. Raw honey, health accumulation opportunity. Talk to you guys later.